In order to configure a supervisor in LN shop floor, we need to do four things. First of all, we need to go to the users form, select our supervisor, and make sure that the attributes are set correctly. So in this case, the key things are that the supervisor is assigned permission groups FT base and FT supervisor. As far as the modules are concerned, if you're running in the cloud, then they should have factory track cloud. If they're running on-premise, they should have factory track base and factory track shop floor ELN. If we then go to the factory track info tab, we should check the user type is set to supervisor. If we want the supervisor to be able to change the clock, then we should select this checkbox here. We need to link the supervisor to an employee, which we'll look at in a second, and we need to make sure that the menu group ID is set to LN sub. So the next thing is to make sure that the supervisor is connected to an employee. So if we go to the employees table and select the appropriate employee, then we need to make sure that the username is set here. So this means that when this supervisor logs in with the supervisor username, they will automatically be linked to their employee number, which in this case is 300102. It's important at this point that the work group that is related to this employee is set to LN admin in our example. This is the work group that supervisors are assigned to so that they can control other employees. The next thing that needs to be done is to assign work groups. So this is where we say LN sup is a work group who contains these employees. We need to make sure that the supervisor is assigned control of this work group. If I tried to assign the supervisor to the work group LN admin, then it would give me a rejection because I'm already linked to that group. So you cannot control your own group. So this is where we say that the supervisor is responsible for the work group LN sub, and the LN sub work group contains these employees. Finally, we need to specify which work centers or resource groups the supervisor is responsible for. We go to supervisor resource groups and we list here the work centers that they are responsible for. So I can add a new work center here and say they are also responsible for this work center and this work center and so on and so forth. So a supervisor can be responsible for one or more work centers or resource groups. Similarly, a resource group can be controlled by one or more supervisors. We can change the preference of these so that we can decide, but in this case, FTWC1 is seen as the primary work center for this particular supervisor. This now means that this supervisor is ready to control the list of employees and work centers in the shop floor module.